folks. Welcome to the channel. You're with the BMD. I'm your host on Major League Broadcasting. We call that short form MLB. And today we got a rockin' rapper. Yeah, I'm using that term, rockin' rapper. I am digging this guy and his song, his new song, which we're going to talk about. And his collaborator is coming in as soon as we make the connection. Folks, welcome to the show, Poetics, sir. Good morning, and thank you for taking the time on this long holiday weekend. How's it going?
Hey, man, I'm good. I'm alive. I'm kicking. Everything is good over here, man. It's real good to see your face.
All right, listen, we're doing a catch-up because we had you on the show on our audio portion way back when we started the YouTube channel, and now we got you visual and audio, so we get to look at that pretty face and that pretty smile. Tell us, what have you been up to since we last caught up about 3-4 months ago?
Honestly, nothing but working, man. Nothing but working on music. Nothing. I got a new puppy, but other than that, it's just been strictly music and my dog.
Your dog. And what about who are you calling a dog, me or you? Just kidding. Listen, what about the music? What about the music? Let's delay a little bit till we bring your collaboration partner in, Cruz. See if we can make the contact connection with him. Maybe we're having a little technical, or he is, but let's wrap a little bit. Tell us about what you've been up to in the music side of things. I know we're going to launch your new release today, but what else have you been doing?
A lot of recording. We've actually had some great opportunities, me and my producers, to meet and record old school fashion out of the basement. But yeah, man, just we've created about 10 new songs that we're just kind of sitting on right now.
Okay, I think Cruz is trying to connect with us.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello. Is that Mr. Cruz?
Yes, sir.
Just gonna get my. Now, do you prefer Mr. Cruz or Tom Cruise?
Mr. Cruz is good.
All right, sir. Well, bring it into the channel. Get your phone. There we go. There we go. Good morning, sir. Welcome to the show.
Good morning. How are you guys doing?
Good, 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 good. We were just talking with your collaborator, Mr. Poetics. And I got to tell you, I played the song around town in my circle, and everybody is rocking to it. It's got to be a number one hit. Let's introduce Poetic. Introduce your partner there and tell us a little bit about him.
Cruz, I honestly don't even know what to say. He's probably the best addition to the team, to myself and Tonics included. He's probably a genius in the works, man. I've seen this kid put together songs in less than 5 minutes. He's super talented. He can sing, he can rap, he can do it all, man. And he's a crazy engineer.
So how are you attracted to him, in the sense of, was it his skill, his wit, his ability? What was it?
His skill, man. His skill level. The quality of his music, and he does it all by himself. It's like top notch.
So, Mr. Cruz, tell us and the listeners and the viewers a little bit about yourself, sir. How did you come together to work on this collaboration with Poetics?
Yeah, so honestly, the collaboration first started with Tonics, the producers that Poetics works closely with.
Okay.
And we met at a Bee Cave event. So it's this event in Toronto where producers come together, artists come together, and just like, it's like a day of collaborating on music. So that's where I met Josh from Tonics. And yeah, we just, you know, I think I laid down some vocals the first day I met Josh. And then from then on, we just started talking back and forth, sending tracks back and forth. And then he introduced me to Poetics. He said, this is one of the artists I work closely with. And then we just started talking with Poetics, you know, just through Instagram, how it, like, everyone's talking now because of COVID and everything. So
yeah,
that's pretty much where it started.
So is your background like the hip hop rapper, or are you a writer, producer, engineer? Tell us, the viewers and listeners, what your component is, not in the song, but your component as an artist yourself.
Yeah. So I started off as an artist. About 5 years ago, I started mixing my own vocals, and, you know, every day I would just slowly do more and more. And eventually I started learning like really in depth when it comes to like vocal mixing and kind of getting into like EQs and compressors and just really, really understanding all that. And yeah, as I went along with my journey, I built this studio down here, and I have my own clients come through. And in terms of my music that I make, I would say it is kind of hip hop. I'm also on like a pop vibe, also on a summer kind of summer music vibe, just like Sazon. And I'm on some different vibes too, some sad vibes, some sad guitar vibes sometimes too. And kind of everywhere, yeah, hip hop, pop, a little bit of rock, summertime kind of songs.
Guys, I think we should collaborate together and write a song about the BMD. What do you think?
We could do it. We could do it all.
So, Poetic, start us off on how the development of this new release. Give us the name of the track and where did it come from? Development, words, poetry, packaging. How did you make it happen?
So, I mean, the last time we spoke, you know, I told you we were heavily influenced on, you know, the Spanish side of things, the reggaeton, the very, very big part of what we do. And I remember telling you that I'm not a big fan of either of those things. You know, reggaeton is just, it wasn't my vibe, but Tonics, my producers, they're real big on it. So they push it every once in a while and I push back and eventually they end up just mixing something and put my voice on it. And that's literally, I think Sazon happened by accident. It was something that my producer created. I had nothing to do with it. I was like, I don't want to touch this song. I recorded to it just for, you know, kicks and giggles. And it's not very, like, if I know BMD, you've heard a lot of my other stuff and it's very, the lyrics are very in depth, but this one I just kind of played around with and threw something on the paper. But I mean, when they hit with that Santana stuff, man, I have to give a big shout out to Mateo, which is the other half of the Tonics team. That kid with the guitar is a magician. And once I heard that, I was on board. Before that, I was like, no, I hate this song. But we introduced Cruz into it and he brought that melody. It was literally just a puzzle piece that fell into all the right places, man, but by accident, to be fair.
Now, what made you turned off initially with hearing the track or a bit of vocal or vibe?
I'm old school, man. Like, everything that I do is deeply rooted in hip-hop, like, you know, lyrical hip-hop. So with music like reggaeton and the Spanish side, it's the influence is the beat. It's not really the lyrics. And that's kind of what turned me off, because I'm a big wordsmith and I like to, you know, I like to turn people's ears by what I say as opposed to the beat. So
the poet.
Yeah, exactly, right? So Sazon was more of a club vibe. We realized that with our demographic, we didn't have much of a female following. And I'm all about the female. So Sazon just kind of hit at the right time. You know, it's summer and Cruz has really got that whole thing down pack right now. That club vibe, that club scene. I'm a little too old for it now, but I'll put my music in the club any day and I'll just listen from outside.
So what about the blend where everybody had their component? Break down how the component worked in the song. Who did what? Who was taskmastered and scheduled to do what?
You know what? Sazon was a lot of moving pieces. We've had Sazon for almost a year now. Like, the beat itself, the original beat, which is what Tonics created, that just sat around in a folder for about a year. And again, with the persistence of my producers, they just kept forcing me to write to it. Once I wrote my piece, that went back to Tonics, and then Tonics sent it to Cruz. I actually wanted Cruz on this song because of the sound. And then once Cruz got his hands on it, it pretty much did the rest from there. When it came to the verse that he did the verse, then he did the mix and mastering. He kind of took over on his own end. And then Tonics, right at the ending, they just started to put that Santana in there to really make it a radio sound.
Beautiful. So Cruz, where did it come for you? Like, the development of the song. I'm really interested in the development side of stuff.
Yeah. So I still remember, this is when my studio was in my room and I got an email from Josh. He said, one of the brothers from Tonics, and he was telling me, you know, I talked to Poetics before this too already, and he was telling me Poetics has a song. They think that, you know, I could vibe with it. They think that it would mesh well with what I got going on, because I'm trying to push out some summer songs before the summer's over. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yeah, like 100%. I'm down to listen to it. And then I listened to Poetics part. And this man just, you know, he does what he did. And he just killed that. And I was like, yo, I need to be a part of this somehow. And I think, honestly, I think the first day they sent it back, I had something ready for them. Or no, I think it might have took a bit for this one, actually. But I did get to it pretty quick. And yeah, just up in my room, you know, I remember I laid the whole verse down in the same sitting. So I did that. I laid down just the lead vocals. I sent it back to them. And then just to see some, like, opinions, if I should keep rocking with what I got going on. And they really loved it. Like, all of them, they were just, like, you know, getting me really amped up and really excited. So I was like, okay, I got to finish this. So then I really got into, you know, all the backup layers and making sure that it sounded, like, very polished, and, you know, get into the mixing, get into all of that stuff. So
now, you said a key word about layers, because I know, yeah, building a song in the development stages, there's lots of moving parts, as you said, and different components. Mm-hmm. But when you guys are writing and collaborating, that could be two different theories, two different thoughts, and then now you add the backbeat or the rhythm beat or guitar or, you know, whatever you're thinking. Tell the viewers how it starts from, let's say, the poetry or the words, then the beat, and you know that beat works, and then you're adding in some old-time, you know, guitar riff. Where does the I'm amazed and mesmerized. Where do the thoughts come from on the blending of all of that? I'm stoned about how that happens, because I'm not that way. I'm the guy born with the voice. I'm the talent on what I do, but I couldn't write A, B, C, the dog ran across the road. It doesn't mean anything to me. When does it become meaningful?
Mm-hmm. In terms of putting it together with the instruments, that's all the guys at Tonics. So they, you know, they handled the guitar riffs and all of that. In terms of vocals and kind of where the meaning comes from, I don't know. I've recently, when I first started making music, I would write everything. But for about, I would say maybe 8 months now, I don't write anymore. I just kind of, I hop on the mic, I let the beat play. And my process, like, kind of going through laying down some vocals, is I listen to the beat. I always start off humming something. You know, I would maybe go through the whole beat one time through and hum a melody, or hum like three different melodies. Then I would listen to those melodies. And then whichever one I like the most, I would usually start with. And then my process when it comes to laying down vocals is I go bar by bar. So I would get a line, and then I would lay the line down and put it in the program that the line's already there. And then I would play the rest of the beat and kind of, like, just build it up piece by piece. And kind of, I don't know, I kind of amazed myself, because, like, I put it together bar by bar, and, like, I don't think about it too much, but then I hear it back and it's like a story. Like, almost all my songs, they always end up like this. They always end up making sense, but I don't put too much thought, like, into making it make sense, but it always kind of, it just, like, natural, comes together nicely. Yeah.
So where did the name Sazon come from? What does it mean?
I'm gonna let Cruz answer that one, because I don't speak a lick of Spanish.
Yeah, so I mean, it's just a season, you know. So it was their name.
What does the word mean?
Season, right?
Season.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it means season. Honestly, I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure it means season. You know, yes. I'm half Spanish, so I understand Spanish. I can't speak it too well, but pretty sure it means season. And yeah, they came up with the name because they had it in the chorus already. So I just vibed with what they were going for. I see they wanted, like, the summer, you know, the summer season type of vibes. Even with the cover art, you can get those. Yeah.
Now, what about the you know, Santana? I know we're saying that. I know it's Tonic's own thing, but the Santana vibe or overtone, what was that injection? Like, how did that riff come up? And because when I've heard the song 10 times at least, and each time it grows all over you.
Oh, wow.
Like, I'm telling you, that's got to get some big airplay on the station. That is a real club sound.
Thank you.
I can take that one. I have to take some credit in terms of what I wanted for Sazon, because yes, it's a club vibe, but I wanted it to reach a lot more demographics, because I noticed that with our demographic, it was kind of very narrow, you know, early 20s to kind of mid 30s. But I wanted grandmothers to dance to this. Like I wanted, you know, I wanted everybody to groove to this. And, you know, BMD, when you told me the wife was grooving, I'm just like, you know.
Oh, grooving. Grooving.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, so I'll tell you the setup at our house. I said, Poetic, I didn't know Cruz at the time, only at name. And I said, this young artist, Poetics, has sent me his latest single. And I had heard it before. And I said, babe, listen to this. Put it on, and maybe 20 seconds in, all of a sudden, all the little bump and the grind started, and she was rocking. She was saying, this is cooking with gas. And I was digging it right on. Listen, speaking about the song, decide which one of you guys, I want you to introduce the song now, and then we're going to put it in, blend it in there. But give the intro to the song to all the viewers listening.
That's poetic.
I'm gonna let Cruz do this. I like. Oh. I like Cruz.
What do you mean? You're on the chorus. You don't want to give a little intro?
All right. So this is a massive project. This is a massive project that we took on, man. Tonics, Cruz, Poetics. It's just the team is too much, man. This is Sazon. I want everybody to say it with the accent too. I'm just going to get all of Toronto to just start speaking Spanish. This is Sazon. This is our baby. This is what we put a lot of work into. So I really hope y'all love it.
I got all of my chicks in one club. Dancing. Hands are all up on that. Goddamn, Bacardi all up in my cup. Handsome, y'all wanna give me a hug? Yes, man. Pull up my hand and let's fall to the flow. Give me a little, now I want some more. Spin you in circles, big booty galore. Drop to the ground and I pick it up slow. I got my mommy with me and we mobbing with me. We at the party, but the gang is with me. If you pour it up, I'ma drink it down. If you talk it perp, then I'ma burn it down. Got the bottles up, put that down. If I pull you close, you better turn around. Till the night is young and now we having fun. And I am the king, so where's my crown? Tonics and Poet, you know we the entree. Tengo mucho hambre. Bring that over here, let me eat like a Sunday. Let's do this the fun way. Put that cherry on top like a Sunday. Then I fly to Colombia. Bring that pack back all the way before Monday. Let's keep it a sack. I only speak facts. Go get my drink and then bring it right back. I don't like to dance. She talk. Give me a chance to feel all that.
Ven baila conmigo. Follow me though. Throw it back like a free throw. Super bonito. Ven baila conmigo. Despacito.
Nice, nice touch. Now, moving right along, is this the only song you guys are sharing, collaborating, or have you become now the dynamic duo, or what's the deal?
That's up to Cruz, man.
Dog, 100%, we're going to be collaborating a lot. It's I think it's the first one we collabed on. But even last time he was here in the studio, we filmed a little thing. Actually, for Sazon, we filmed a video, and we were in talks about more collaborations. I showed him a couple beats, and he said he's vibing with it, but he just had to bounce that day. So definitely, definitely going to be some collabs in the future coming together, and they're going to be crazy. Like, you know what Poetic said? He's not even usually on these type of vibes, these Sazon vibes. So like, and I'm not always on these vibes too. So I know our future music is just going to be all types of, like, you know, all types of genres. So I'm excited for
Wait till we start doing some music that we actually like doing. So
I mean, I like this music too. This guy, I don't know, but yeah.
So is it gonna have a Latin Spanish flavor, all your stuff, or are we gonna hear, you know, Tone Loke, where it's a bit of AC/DC and then the old Tone school Loke rap, or what's in the future with you guys?
Tone Loke, I love that, man. No, honestly, if I could keep it West Coast, I'd keep it West Coast every day, man. But yeah, you know what? I we haven't even talked about Cruz's girlfriend. She's another beautiful soul. She's got so much talent. I honestly think for the rest of this year, it's just going to be, you know, collaboration after collaboration. And, you know, Tonix is on board 100%. And I just look forward to the next thing we do, because the beat that they sent me recently, I plan to eat up. I plan to eat right up. So the next one, look out for, you know, me, Cruz, and his girlfriend, Mez. She's super talented.
Now, with phase 3 opening up on the COVID-19 pandemic, are there some club dates or contests or bar gigs as things continue to open up? Are you going to get on stage, get together and rip it up, or what?
I'm itching, man. I'm itching. We had a show scheduled for August 1st, but the bar canceled. So it is still kind of weird, right? It's still kind of iffy, but, you know, worst case scenario, we'll just pull up to a park somewhere and just put on a show for everybody, man.
What about the launch of Sazon? What about the launch on it national and the Spotify's and iTunes and all that stuff? Where are you getting out? Where are you pounding the beat? That song, dudes, you got to get out.
So it hasn't. So I don't want to give away too much, but right. it is in the works right now to get our song played out. This is going to sound weird, but we're going to get this song played out in Trinidad and Tobago. I got a radio host out there that is loving this song, and it's got that Caribbean vibe, and it's got a Spanish vibe, but the Caribbean loves the Spanish vibe. So right now that's in the works to get it pushed out there. It's everywhere though. It's on Spotify, it's on iTunes, it's on Good, it's basically everywhere. And you know, BMD, I'll share all the links with you, of course.
Yes.
But this, yeah, we're also in the works as well. We're looking to get on some of the bigger radio stations. There's a lot of stuff moving on in the background, but I had to hit you up first, man. You were there at day one.
Oh, so absolutely. I'm so happy you did. And guys, when you're referring to other hosts, there's only one host, and that's the BMD.
The BMD.
The BMD. Listen, what about, are you going to do stuff? Let's pretend in a good world that things continue to keep opening up. Are you going to do stuff together live where, you know, it's under a promoter's hat and, you know, meet Poetic and Cruz at the Elma Combo? They're going to be rocking all night and spitting the chiclets, not spitting the words, or vice versa.
I mean, yeah, like, you know, like you said, August 1st, we were planned to, you know, have a collab show. I was, Poetics was headlining, so I was going to be one of the openers. So we actually had it planned, you know, that was going to be our first kind of show together. And Sazon dropped around the same time, so it would have all came together. But unfortunately, didn't end up happening. But, you know, for sure, we're going to make up for it and plan something in the future, 100%, multiple shows.
Now, what about the, how did you know when it was a hit? Let's say it's all spit and polished, smoothed out, edited out, techno engineered out. and now you're all sitting down together with your team and the ba-boom, ba-boom comes on. How did you know that's it?
For me, I actually knew it was it as soon as they sent it over. I was like, wow, I need to be a part of this. My vocals weren't even on it, but I just knew, you know, somehow I had to be a part of it. So from the get, it was a hit. And then when I put on my vocals to it, I just like spiced it up with a little more singing, a little more, you know, dancey vibe-ness kind of to it. And, you know, from the start, I knew it was always special. Honestly, as soon as they sent it over, these guys at Tonix, their production is ridiculous. Every song is so cinematic. And every time they come through, that's what we tell them. So, yeah, I knew it was a hit from the start.
What about the exposure? I know you can't tell everything and you're getting it out there, but what is the industry people saying at the start? And then outside of friends and family, are you hearing like this has got a good hook? You know, this is catchy. Like, I like the word catchy because it grabs your attention right away.
It hasn't, honestly, I think that's when I realized it was a hit. I didn't get on board with this song until maybe last week. I mean, like I said, we've had it recorded. My part has been done for months. This song has just been sitting. But it was really when you're hearing people that you don't know, like people that you have never met, and they're just like, yo, this song has got something. I knew it was a hit when I heard with that whole Santana piece. That didn't come until a couple weeks ago. That whole guitar riff there wasn't in the song. It wasn't even a thought. It wasn't until a couple weeks ago they put together this crazy, you know, guitar part. And then we were sharing it with friends and family, but then friends and family were sharing it with other people, and they were just like, man, y'all need to put some firepower behind this song.
You know, if that is, say, in my time, older than you guys, that was, say, on the 45 record, vinyl, that was A-side. Have you got a B-side follow-up?
You know, we don't, but if it's very easy to do, because I would love to have a female artist on this, and I think Mez, which is Cruz's girlfriend, I think she would be an insane addition to this, man. An insane addition to this song.
Why is that?
That girl can sing, man. And she's got this, sexy flow. She's, you know, she's pretty. She's attractive. I hate to say it to Cruz while he's on this call.
Trust me, bro.
She's just got the whole package, man. She's very, very talented, very attractive. And I think with this whole, it being a female-directed song, I just think she would complement it in so many ways.
And in the time, in the state of world we live in now, that, you know, with things that are going on with the Me Too movement and that, girl power is extreme right now. And listen, as it should be, because, you know, just because you guys are hot tickets don't mean that the ladies in your life aren't hot tickets in the same of ability and, you know, progress and, you know, male, female thing. You know, like there's tons of good female artists out there too that can shake the guys down. And I'm digging that. I'm just trying to feel the vibe. So is Mez going to be the attraction to the B side of that 45 vinyl or what?
That's a good idea, to be honest. I think it's a very good idea.
We never really discussed it, to be fair with you. Sazon came out on Thursday, so I'm still trying to wrap my head around the next direction. But man, I think if Sazon picks up enough speed, we might as well throw her on there, because that's just going to take it to a whole nother plateau.
Hey, maybe we need Mez and the BMD collaborating on the B side of that new record.
100%, man.
So guys, what is in store? What's up next? Tell the viewers. I know you teased me, you couldn't say everything, but give me a little more tease to the viewers where we can do another follow-up in a couple of few months. I'm attracted by your guys' career. You're full of life, you're full of piss and vinegar, and I like that. And I'm into the young bloods, being an older guy, but look, it tease the viewers with something that's breaking next?
We got a music video, man.
Oh, yeah.
We got a music video.
music video, is it going to accompany Sazon? Is that the idea? Yeah. Okay, I'm liking that.
Yeah.
Why I asked that, we had Mega Sean on about 8 weeks ago. And the night before he came on, he did two 1-minute videos of the tracks, and they were dynamite. So that song needs the dancer in it, and the heavy guitar and all that. I'm digging that whole vibe.
Oh, we're ahead of you, brother. We're ahead of you. So
tell me. I'm trying to pull it out of you.
Should I show a little snippet?
Yeah, we got a video out right now that we shot with a drone. We got some drone footage of Toronto, man, some Toronto skylines, the lakeshore. That one I'm for sure going to send you very shortly. But that's how we were teasing Sazon before it dropped. We put out about a minute video of some crazy drone footage, some pretty girls. So that's just a teaser. But in terms of a full-blown music video, we have a great supporter by the name of Karma Management, who's going to put a decent little budget together for a music video for this. We're obviously going to aim for a club scene for a lot of it. But yeah, we got some things cooking to kind of complement the track as it. Because, I mean, the track on its own is strong, but you need that YouTube content. You need that music video content. So that's coming very shortly.
Guys, we got about a minute to go. I want you to give your shout outs on your social medias, your IDs, emails, how people can connect with you. Because I'm thinking when they're hearing this song, they're going to blow up like I did. So let's start with Poetic. How can people reach you?
IG, first and foremost, poetics_the_poet, Poetics the Poet. Pretty much all my social media, Twitter, Facebook, it's all under Poetics the Poet. I mean, our music right now is on all of the big streaming sites, Spotify, Google Play, iTunes. It's everywhere. So just type in Poetics the Poet, man. You'll see your boy. I'm looking pretty right now. So look me up.
Cruz, how about you? Go ahead.
So my music, same thing. It's out everywhere. And Cruz is spelled Cruize. You can find me anywhere, YouTube, SoundCloud, and all the paid ones. And you can also find me on Instagram at cruz.x.
Guys, we're out of time. Great having you. Thanks for taking the time. We're going to catch up again in a few months to see where we are together. And so much thanks having you there. Folks, you've been listening to our YouTube channel, MLB, Major League Broadcasting. I'm your host, the BMD, and we've had rap hip-hop artist Poetics on and rap hip-hop artist Cruz on the show today. Guys, take care, and don't forget, if you like what you heard, like what you saw, hit that subscribe button, thumbs up, and the likes. I'll see you later, guys.
All right.
Bye-bye. Thank you.